All right, y'all. So let's talk about effectively doing questions, how many you should do, and how to build that muscle memory and stamina. So when I tell y'all to prepare in a certain fashion and to make sure you are effectively studying, but also building up your endurance to be able to sit and do 150 questions or 175 for boards, this is what I mean. So we're all busy. You're working, you have family life, you have other activities, whatever, and you're trying to fit in the time to do questions, but not just to complete them, but to be able to adequately study while doing those. Number one, when you're doing questions, I don't even care if it's the three that I do daily or whatever. One, sit down a time. So I say start small. So for example, say your first week you're doing 10 questions Monday through Friday or whatever, whatever works with your schedule. Doing 10 questions where you know that you could adequately sit down, do the 10, and be able to review the rationales. And what do I mean by that? So do 10 questions, already know where you're going to do your questions from, what source, whatever. So you're not spending this time that you have allotted to like thumbing through or trying to order some or trying to see which ones you want to do. No, go ahead and have that set up for today. Do your 10 questions. Review the 10 to see what you have correct. Write down what you have incorrect. As I say, like, look, I have a notebook because I'm around. I have to see it. Get you a little notebook. Nothing expensive. I do these because they have multi sections that I can write in. But even when I was preparing for boards, this is what I did. So I tell y'all to have a notebook because everything we do is for a purpose, a strategy, right? We don't have any time to waste and go back and do double work. So when you do these 10 questions, the ones that you get incorrect, I want you to review the rationales. And so say you missed three of the 10. Write those three questions in here that you have incorrect. So say it was a hypertension question. Write the rationale, right? And then every evening or whatever the next day, if you did them at night or whatever, review those one time before you lay down. Just review the three that you got wrong because it begins to be a quick tool and resource that you can review over. So then you do your next 10 the next day. Same thing, and you're building. But say whatever day it is during that week that you have more time off. So I'm just going to use the weekend for example, but say like you did this Monday through Friday, did 10 questions each day, and Saturday is your day that you are most free. I know in healthcare that's not our typical schedule, but I'm just doing this to make it an easy display for you. So on Saturday, do 25 questions. Sit down and do 25. Still utilize this to review. If you miss any, put them in the rationale book because you're building this. It doesn't need to be in 12 different areas, or if you want to do something like a note or a document or whatever on your iPad or your tablet, your phone, whatever you do, so you can utilize this resource to keep looking back through, keep it in one source so you're not going back. Because again, our time is limited because we have so many tasks and things and duties. So if you sit here and you are having to go to multiple places or you're having to look back or you're trying to remember what you missed, you're not going to do it. Stop lying to yourself. So then you did the 10 each week, each day. Then on that free day, you did more, 25, right? Because we're trying to build. Almost like you're in the gym lifting weights and now you're up in your weight, right? All right, so you did that on Saturday. Now, next week, instead of 10 every day, do your 25 every day. Then on your Saturday, where you have more time, do 50. The following week, 50 every day. Bump it up to 100. And you're starting to build that endurance. And so you want to keep doing that. If you have a shorter amount of time that you're preparing for boards, then of course you're going to have to start with a larger number, right? So that you can build up. But the thing that this allows you to do, you're doing questions to test your application, where you're consistently getting things incorrect, you're reviewing those deficits, right? From the rationales that you're keeping a log of. Then on top of that, you're building your endurance to be prepared four boards to be able to sit through and push through these things. Like it doesn't happen overnight, you know what I mean? And then also know your study style, know your learning style. If you have test anxiety, if you get flustered or overwhelmed, this is how you can practice your scratch sheet, dump sheet, it's called multiple things, while doing all of these things. And also, for example, like me, I know when I get to 50 questions, I need a little woosah moment, right? My brain is going a mile a minute. Test anxiety is kicking in. I'm starting to question how I'm doing. So every 50, I practice like, all right, deep breathing, pause, I know I probably look real crazy on camera for in the testing center, but I don't care because I'm trying to reach a goal. So if you got to close your eyes, breathe, pray, meditate, whatever you got to do, do what works for you. But practice that as you're doing this so that when it's test day, you're able to execute. You know what I'm saying? Like, just like, and I know everybody says that I reference sports and I didn't realize I do this so much, but I guess I do. So with that, just like you would be dribbling, shooting in the gym, practicing your shots before game day, do the same thing here. We don't just walk in the gym and start, thinking that you're going to meet all the points. You might hit some, but you would be much more successful if you are practicing and you are working out and conditioning yourself. No different. The same skills we use with everything else is the same. So try those steps. I'm gonna run it back to you and tell me how it works for you. So set a schedule, write it out. Make it plain, because once you write that thing down, it becomes a little bit more real. Some of you need to go ahead and schedule your test date because that makes it real. It puts fire to your behind so that you can stop pushing back the finish line, right? So go ahead, set whatever that time frame is. Hey, I'm gonna study for 3 weeks. Hey, I'm gonna study for 4 weeks. I've been reviewing, reviewing, reviewing. Now I want to see where I am with questions, right? I want to see how my application is, if I need to cover more things, etc. So with that, for these 3 weeks, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start out with 10 questions on each of these days. And think about your schedule. Okay, Tuesdays are my busiest day. So I know I'm not gonna do questions on that day. Stop setting yourself up for failure. If you know that you are not gonna get to it, one, don't set yourself up that you're gonna beat yourself up because you didn't get those things done. Two, don't sit over here and make these overzealous and overachieving goals that you know you're not going to execute, and then it makes you go down the rabbit hole of feeling as though that you have not completed what you need to or beating yourself up about it, right? So look at your schedule realistically. Give yourself these days. I don't care if it's 5 days, if it's 3 days, do something so that you can build the endurance, right? So you're doing this, do your 10 on your lightest day. That's where you're going to do those most questions, 25. And whatever that number is on those days, know that that's what you're building for the next day. So if you've done 10 all week and you know next week you're trying to bump up to 25, so on that light day, you need to see what that 25 feels like. Let's see if you can push that weight, right? So 25, then next week, all right, we're going to try to do 25 and we're going to build it. But as you're doing this, you're putting it in a time frame that you are able to adequately do the questions and not say, oh, I started doing 10, I was focused on 10, and then the last set of 10, I needed to run my kids somewhere, or I needed to cook dinner, or I had to get out of here to get to work, and so I started kind of rushing through. No, set a time that you can actually sit down and do it. That's why I say, really look at your schedule, really allot the time. Don't sit here and say you're gonna do 1,000 questions this week, and you don't have time to do all that. So yeah, you're trying to meet this number, but are you effectively studying? No. So do an amount that you can do, build on it, but make sure it's a time frame that you can actually sit down and do it. Write it in your notebook, put it in your iPad, your tablet, your phone, whatever you need to do. Review it each day. Review it each day and continue to build and watch how your scores change on your test and come back and thank me later. All right, bye y'all.